Hi guys. So this is I'm just going to show you how to do something really cool, which is how to so if you have an ATEM, you literally have your volume mixer inside of there, a VDU menu, a viewed menu, which is where it shows all your audio mixers. You can also do this with like a timer too. If you set a specific recorder timer, you could do this. So basically, if you have a multi-action open, so in like OBS, they have multi-actions, which has 8, 18, or 25. If you have 25 settings, then you set it to 25 by going to settings, and then go down to the multi-view at the bottom and change it to 25 by per horizontal. It'll show the program feed and then the actual preview feed. And then, if you want to basically, if you have, because if you want a actual other one, a like another view of the thing, a like another multi-action, you literally could take the thing. And I mean, if you want to basically have a actual timer, then you just create a timer, put a countdown timer if you want it to use it for how long you've been recording. Because let's say you want to make a 30-minute video, you make a 30-minute countdown timer, or you can find one. I basically you can make one with iMovie. I mean with Keynote or any like 3D editing software or pretty much anything, and make it kind of sophisticated so it counts down and stuff like that. So you can see on screen how long you're recording. And if you have a scene, for example, if you don't use like a starting scene, for example, like I have, you can basically put have a begin scene, or you can have it, or you don't have to have a beginning scene. You could basically, so I have a beginning scene just so I can go back through actually there at the for recording video. But if you don't have like a starting scene, you could use that as your timer, because I have 8, because the one is beginning, which just is the start, which you guys don't see much of. Then I have start scene, which will go through the scene, which will count down for 30 seconds. And then it'll start, then it'll just go to cam, then it'll go to host, and once it goes to host, it would basically, I guess, it will do hosting, and then I can basically go through capture, desktop, Mac, and tablet, and audio mixer. You should make a sync audio mixer, I mean a sync audio mixer, and then put all of your actual files in there if you want. You don't have to put any files in here, but I put some in here just so it could see actually them. Then you make a desktop one in audio mixer. You make a desktop screen capture. Once you do the desktop screen capture, you have to set it so you have to move your audio mixer somewhere where it wouldn't go onto the side here or not here, because if you put it here and you exit, it'll close. If you put it here all to the side, it'll disappear. So how you have it is an audio mixer would be floating, and you can't just suddenly quit OBS, or you have to go back up to docs and then re-enable audio mixer. So if you want to like do that. But so with this, you can have a multi-action. I mean in like the multi-action in the stream deck, you just have it boot to multi-view. And once you have it boot to multi-view, you can literally just have this scene in there that says audio mixer. I have mine at the bottom, so it'll be over here in the corner, and so I don't switch to it. And to make it even easier, so I can still see all my audio mix levels inside of the thing, because if I just have a and this is without having the actual audio source being in my start scene, I have each individual, which is in my case Roland Audio, Desktop Audio, and Rodecaster, or just Rode, all in each individual scene I use when tab them in tablet, Mac, desktop, capture, cam, and the Mac is just a, when it goes into multi-view, it can show the multi-view. Or if I have OBS minimized, I literally can just record the screen, but it's mainly aimed at using it with the multi-view. So, because if we use this and minimize this, I don't know what will happen with the audio mixer. It might disappear, it might stay up, I'm not sure. So, it stays up. So, go like that. So, the audio mixer will still be actually up there, because you can't move this out of the scene. But you can basically lower this down like so, and you can show what's on your desktop. You could basically then edit this out if you wanted to, but it's just the audio mixer, which is good for showing levels and stuff like that, so you can see it. So you can do computer stuff right here and stuff, and so then you bring it back up when you're done. But this is mainly aimed at if you want a audio inside of the multi-view, because it's not made handily, so it's not made built in OBS. You can do this yourself, but, and I just showed you really quickly how to do it. So thanks for watching.